Ciel is standing next to us right now, and he said, "Sorry, sorry, KJ, sorry." I'm not even mad. That was a good match. I think he's gonna do well later on in the tournament.
Blair is playing as Bison, and I think it's a really difficult matchup for Bison. Well, another difficult matchup for Bison.
Well, Fan keeps Bison out pretty well.
Well, not only he keeps Bison out, he can apply really strong pressure. Since
that too. That's
normals last on block and a lot of his normals.
That too. And the anti-air.
Yes.
Bison literally cannot take into the air in that matchup. Well, so far it's everything's really patient, like not a lot of stuff going on.
Yeah, it's like back and forth.
Like Xian is pressing a lot less buttons than we are used to.
Well, I guess he knows the matchup. He knows that against Bison, it's not a wise option to press buttons.
So back to the screen.
And it looks like Xian is literally doing all. He's almost doing nothing, but he has significant life lead.
Yeah, that's Fang. That's those little hits that count. That's poison that counts. All that stuff.
Nice rock, Xian.
Like, Bison really doesn't get to play a lot in this match. That's how it looks right now. Nice
shimmy.
Grab and into stun, into big damage, into another setup, into another grab, and that's a match. Perfect KO. Well, that was setup after setup after setup, and Claire was not ready for sure.
Well, at least I won't be the only person who was perfected by Xian on stream.
I guess a lot of people are gonna be today.
And it's interesting that people think that Fang is a low tier character.
I don't know. He's got good normals. He doesn't have good punishers. That's what makes him not that good. Oh my God! What a punch. Like how did Bison walk into that flip kick?
And again, Bison just can't do anything against Fang.
Yeah,
and another
looks like that. It's really, really...
stop jumping.
Really not much that Bison can do to get out. Okay, he gets a jump in, gets a dash. Xian is sleeping. And now he woke up. Actually, Xian loves that fuzzy guard at the end of rounds, or when he stuns with that, he uses it a lot.
Yeah, and I think players just...
Right now, though, it was a really interesting moment when Xian does the medium... How's that called? The advancing move. He always spaces it so that you can punish it, and so he presses buttons right afterwards to counter poke you.
Well,
now, Psycho Blast did punish it.
Oh, crash on the combo? Finally find some damage. Stun is building up. Jump in.
Ooh.
And Xian is stunned.
Stun is around. Well done, Claire. Well done.
It's just one opening.
Let's
and
go.
Like, Claire took the round.
Actually, Fang has a lot of trouble getting out of Bison's pressure as well.
Well,
like, what can he do? So it's actually whoever gets the pressure first.
Well, Frank has a
nice.
Really good super, but you're not always have the full bar stock, so...
He has that, but you can read that. Good. Good throw back into the corner. What's it gonna be? My God.
Okay, reverses out. Just like that. Buttons on the wake up.
Oh my God. Too much pressure. Jabs and wake up, let's go, 3.5.
Great blocks from Xian.
And cross up and a throw. Yeah.
Oh, for Xian.
Like, Xian plays really, really fast. It's really hard to counter all the options Fang has.
Yes, you just don't have time to adapt to this.
Exactly. Out of all the international players today, Sian is like, his decision making is the fastest by far.
Yes, and
he just doesn't let you breathe.
And I would say he uses a lot of gimmicks, but it seems like all of his movements, you just can't predict any of it.
Just they cannot.
He cross-ups you, he doesn't cross-ups you, he throws you, he just hits something with pass on block.
A lot of options you can't really concentrate on all of them. So you don't have any time to like start your game. I don't know, really hard. So obviously now we have Fidoskin, KGB Fidoskin on stream. Crowd is hype for it. Let's see who he plays.
I believe he plays Fang as well.
I mean, who he plays against.
Oh.
So they say he's playing Will Tupac.
Oh, this is gonna be hype.
Laura from France, right?
I believe so. And I'm actually looking forward to see Sian versus Fidoskin in Greg Finals. Because Fang Mirror is... you don't really often see that.
Well, it's a long way to go to Grand Finals, so let's see how it turns out. So, for all of you who are watching, right now you can see Will Tupac on the left player cam and Fidoskin on the right one. So that long-haired gentleman in the hoodie is Fidoskin, and the other handsome gentleman is Will Tupac.
I'm actually wondering, what does KGB mean? Like, they have a...
It stands for Communist Gaming Bears. Something like that.
Really?
Yep, it does.
So you ask...
I mean, they have a some online group or something where it's written.
Yes, and that way I was wondering.
So, Fidoskin mostly plays Fang, but lately he's been dabbling with Chun-Li and also Nash.
Yes.
He plays a lot of characters, but I don't know who he plays in tournaments right now.
Well, I believe he uses Nash as a counterpick for certain characters.
We'll see. We'll see. Oh man, I'm really excited for those European versus Russian matches. Like, they're so intense.
Yeah, I agree.
It's like the greatest chance Russian players have to show themselves. Like, we don't travel a lot because it's far and it's expensive. And not everyone has the opportunity to travel. So when they come here to Russia, it's a big deal.
Yes. So come to Moscow. It's really fun here. Well, yep. Not only to Moscow. We have some other big tournaments like EFA, Yekaterinburg Fighting Arena.
Yeah, we do. But MFA is certainly the biggest one.
Yes.
It's the evil for Russia, basically. Yes. So.
Doskin.
Chun-Li.
It's Chun-Li.
Well, I told you, he's been playing Chun-Li lately. It's actually, it's a good pick for him. He likes to play the neutral game, and who is better than Chun-Li?
Well, I believe it's a good pick for anybody, since I think she's just the better character in the game, the best character in the game.
Yeah, maybe she might be. Okay, so it's Laura versus Chun-Li, Melty Will Tupac versus KGB Fidoskin. Let's go. And
jump in.
Starts with the jump around. Into reset into common control. Legs, pressure.
Way to pop chance.
Okay. Well, Tsipak does not challenge the legs, so he just lets Fedoskin do that.
Oh. And the crowd is really hyped for Fedoskin.
Of course, nice shimmy, but doesn't convert it into anything.
Nice control from Fedoskin.
Now she's V3.
Right into the corner.
Again, nice shimmy. Again. Shimmy's in really well.
Flex.
Should be a good combo. Stun, and that's a round. Nice, that's good. That's very, very convincing. He didn't let Will Tsipak do right about anything.
Yeah, that's how you shut down Laura.
Sure.
Since if you dead.
Okay, that's a combo. More pressure into grab in the corner. Nice dash under. It's really good dash under.
Just me on the corner right now.
Okay, everything gets blocked.
Well, Tsipak trying to hang out something just like that.
Nice.
He accepts the cage. Why not?
Again, reversals again. Good decision, actually. It's a good one. Everyone presses buttons after the activation. Yo, activation, dash up, grab, whatever works. Big damage in the setup. Right.
Huge jumping from Fedoskin.
Like, you see? Will Tsipak tried to shimmy him back. Like, he dashed in and then walked back, but Fedoskin jumped. He didn't press buttons on his wake-up, he jumped.
That was really smart for him.
Like, I guess he was expecting something like, I don't know, maybe a common grab on his wake-up, because that would have killed. So, good match from Fedoskin. Very, very dominating first round, and then a solid second round. Really good. Let's see what adjustments will Tsipak make.
It seems like Will Tsipak is taking his time to think things over.
That's actually the first time we've seen that.
Yeah,
so let's see how he adjusts. Okay.
Just like that, in and out.
A lot of movement from Laura, and that's what she does. Okay. A lot of stun, and that's stun. And that
this
might,
is perfect.
That could be it. Fedoskin
still has a chance, but not anymore.
Skills in and out, and crouch medium kicks. Solid. Really
seems
strong,
like adjustments
really
made by Will Tsipak are really working out.
Like, he just upped the tempo.
Yeah.
Started making more decisions.
And
right now he's back to that slow neutral based game, which Chun Li does
dominates.
Better.
Yes, she dominates the game.
And that shows, you see? Like, right now, Fedoskin has the momentum, like that the reversal might have changed it. But now they're back to neutral, which is good for Chun Li. Again, no challenge on the legs.
Well, it's really difficult to challenge.
Like, you have to practice it, right? It's consistent for every chick, for every character.
And it's really fast move.
Nice. Perfect skin back. What a round, come on. Why is that so hype? Perfect all over the place. So match point for Fedoskin, actually. And they both got a lot of meter. A lot of meter.
Fedoskin almost had his super bar stock.
Yo, reads the...
Nice, he does his spinning bird kick combo.
I'm back to neutral. And again, no challenge with the legs. So right now, Fedoskin is gonna go ham with legs, I guess. You see? Legs.
I don't think it's a good decision. Since when you're doing... Yeah, that's punishable.
You punish into activation, into more damage.
Oh my god.
Into resets, nice jump.
Nice,
again,
yes,
he jumps.
Nice sensor from Fedoskin.
Like, right now, Will Tsipak, red, and EX SPD, but Fedoskin jumped again. And that's unfortunately much for Will Tsipak.
Well, that's where Laura shines.
Yeah.
She has really strong mix-ups and...
That's really true.
You aren't ready for them. You just never.
Like, you have to read. You have to make a read.
Yes.
You read wrong, you get... You lose, like, 20% of your life.
Well, if not 50% of your life.
Well, if she has resources, yes, she deals damage, like, the best of them. Round one. So,
It's 1-1 right now.
Most matches are set.
It's gonna be really intense.
I guess so. But right now they're playing the neutral game again. First hit goes to Laura. Nice jump on the common web.
And again, he doesn't drop his spinning board kick combo.
It's pretty important to Chun-Li to get as much damage as she can.
Yes, and I've seen a lot of great players dropping this combo. So it's really good, really great from Fidoskin.
Nice. Fidoskin just waited a little bit after the overhead, and then he pressed button to kind of respect his minus. Right now it's a good round for Fidoskin. He plays at a very comfortable range. Like, he doesn't let Laura start her offense.
No, yes, he just controls the space really well.
Like, you see, he's out of forward half punch, out of dash something, just a little further.
Again, it's a flex! And that's the round!
Let's go! Match point for Dustin.
And the crowd goes wild.
Like, literally everyone is cheering for Fidoskin right now. So, try to get in with EX Kikokin.
Nice blocks from Fidoskin.
Mix-ups, wait.
No.
Spends a lot of meter to keep his mix-ups going. Oh, walk-up
okay,
grab.
Okay, gets a throw.
Those balls on Fidoskin, just walk-up grab.
Okay, that's not a bad position for Fidoskin, but he has a life deposit, so he has to figure something out.
Nice, Santaya.
Great reaction.
Let's go Fidoskin. Keep it patient, but... Nice
entire. And a mix-up after that.
More legs. Again, he executes. Plus!
Yes, punish from Fidoskin. Laura's in the corner. Oh, gets himself cornered. That's very unfortunate.
Really
EX SBK? No, he doesn't press buttons. He paid for that.
So much point for both players. Like, I think that B-skill into the corner was wrong. That's what's
yes.
Costing around.
That's, it's almost never, well,
like
jumping in the corner.
Chun-Li, like, she has setups with ambiguous cross-ups with B-skill, but that really wasn't one of them.
Yes.
Still very patient neutral game.
Just one opening.
No one takes any risk. Oh, that was a jump OS actually. He OS'd the tech.
Oh, does it still exist?
Very close to stun. EX. Come on.
Fidoskin
pushes. Well, it's a good time to push actually. But right now it's not. Okay, back to neutral.
Laura spent her V-meter.
Right now we're back to neutral.
Fidoskin has
and a
really
great walk-up throw. Nice.
Fidoskin takes.
Like, two walk-up throws bring Fidoskin a match. Well, that was really good. Great patience from both players, actually. They just played that neutral game really well, both of them.
Yes, but the thing is, that Chun-Li gets more from patience.
Yes, she does. But Fidoskin didn't let Will Tupac start his mix-ups, his offense.
Yes, really convincing
really
play.
Kept him away really well, kept him in neutral. And really important thing, Will Tupac never challenged the legs. Like, Fidoskin...
Like, not a single time.
Yep. Yes. Not even tried. Like, Fidoskin got a lot out of it. A lot of meter, a lot of initiative. Like, it's a free way, basically.
So, that's why you learn matchups.
Yep, that's why you do. So, the first one falls down. It's Will Tupac going into loser's bracket. Once again, Russia is not free.
But he still may come back.
Yep. Good times, really good times. It's a great opportunity for Russian players. Like, I'm really happy that this happened. So we are we're probably about to see FLCL again on stream.
He's playing against
Yapa, right?
Yapa.
The Yapa, right? Yeah. So FLCL versus Yapa. Yapa's Chun Li also, right? Is he? He played Chun Li in SF4, and I think there is no reason for him not to play her now.
I think everyone is Chun Li. And who's not Chun Li? That he is Mika. Well, I mean, we've seen a lot of Ru players, but they didn't make it to. Well, maybe some of them qualified, but.
I take a photo, yeah?
I've mostly seen them in pool.
Okay, players are checking the buttons. Really nice feature of Street Fighter V. You can, like, preview buttons. That's a great addition.
Yeah, so you don't have to load the game.
Like, probably the one thing they did right.
I see what you did here.
Yo, OP about to go.
Would you kindly?
Okay, now it's correct. So it's Mika versus Chun Li. I guess FLCL already played Yapa online, maybe. So, and he's probably familiar with the matchup. But I'm not sure, actually. I'm not sure. Let's see what's gonna happen. Like, on paper, it's really in favor of Chun Li.
Yes, I agree. Just like three sweeps in a row. Why not? And I believe if a sweep by Chun Li is done right, Mika can punish it.
There goes.
Yo,
drops the combo.
FLCL got himself on it.
Okay, like, really strange. Yapa does a good job challenging crouch, hard punch, and block, but when he whiffs, he does nothing. Like, as if he wasn't ready. Really strange.
Great block from FLCL. No challenge on jumping.
And that's a challenge on legs, but yes. Unfortunately, EX has BK afterwards. Okay, so the first round goes to Yapa. Like, I know FLCL practiced that crouch medium punch against legs. Another wake up SBK. Yo, that was pretty dirty. Overhead. Yo, regular SBK, that's something that should not hit you.
Something here.
So back into the corner.
Corner time.
And now he tries to whip punish and does a jab. Nicely done. Yeah, Chun Li.
Nice.
Man, Chun Li has so many buttons to challenge the space and, like, to control the space in front of her. That's really difficult. Yes, really difficult for anyone.
And that's what makes you really strong.
Like, she can just press buttons and be okay.
Yeah.
Like. Oh, that great low profile with the crouch medium kick.
And FLCL is trying to get in, but he really
struggles. It's really hard.
Yapa is really good at controlling space.
And that's a really, really solid and strong round from Yapa. He's on match point.
And Yapa
FLCL
is
has
the second
to
player who does just confirm into SBK. That's really good to see. Like, it means they've been training.
No, that's a decision.
Kick throw into the corner. Slide out.
Okay, he just dashes back out of Mika's mix. Punish on slide. Solid, good punish. Gonna be good damage. just like this, a jump,
safe
jump setup.
Actually, he doesn't confirm.
Oh man, that's really, really hard. Only a real master can come back from this.
Okay. But FLCL. This can be huge, but FLCL should be.
Oh my God!
Ready
wake up!
For that.
Wake up, low short. Yes. I mean, what the hell?
It's either low short or EXSBK.
But you block both low. Why not? Well, unfortunately, my teammate is out of the tournament. And Yappa moves on into loser's bracket.
But we still have Fedoskin.
Yeah, we still have Fedoskin. Well, that's those things happen. Chun-Li is really difficult to play against.
Yep. Just like FLCL says.
Держись в кадре.
All right.
So. In a couple of minutes, we're gonna have our next match. Let's see who that's gonna be. So I'm gonna say a couple of words in Russian, guys. I can't hold it. Очень жаль, что FLCL не прошел дальше в турнире. Очень жаль, я очень за него болел. Очень был крутой у него сет с Problem X. К сожалению, проиграл. Ну, с Япо было как-то прям совсем трудно. Было видно, что, короче, тяжело Мике. Че, вообще что угодно делать. Не повезло.
С Клером играть принялся смотреть. Пойду, конечно, сайт. Будем сайт на ответ. Я же говорю, что ты ебошь.
So, once again, we're streaming this tournament on two channels. This very one, Twitch.tv/FightingWu and Twitch.tv/FightingWu1. So, load them up both. And have as much Street Fighter as you can. We still don't know who our next pair of players are.
And it seems like it is gonna be Clear.
Okay, so we're gonna have Cancer versus Claire. Cancer, yeah.
What a good nickname.
Yep. So Cancer is one of those who qualified through Road MFA events. And Claire, he dropped to loser's bracket. He lost to Xian, right? Claire lost to Xian.
Unfortunately, I can't confirm that.
I think so. Unfortunately, we don't have a bracket online, so it's really hard to follow along the bracket because we don't have it online. Because we're in Russia and we have our very Russian
and
Kansas, bracket
believe,
system.
Is playing Bison.
Yeah,
as well?
He's a Bison. He's a Bison player from Perm. It's a city in Russia, Perm. You know.
And Problem X said earlier today that. He used to play Bison, if I'm correct.
Yeah, he did.
And earlier today he said that he thinks that Bison is garbage. Like, his walk speed is terrible.
All he has is pressure.
Yes.
But he has to start it somehow.
Yes, and he doesn't have a lot of ways to get in.
Yeah, and also get out.
Well, yes. And he also can do shimmy.
He doesn't have to. With his throw range, he doesn't even have to. Like, he can just do this, and you're already scared of the throw. Okay, so players are getting ready. Like, I actually don't see neither Kansa nor Claire right now on cams. No, I see Cancer. He's on the left one. That's Cancer.
Yeah.
So we're gonna have. So like I'm not gonna tell you who's playing on the other stream, or else you're all gonna go there and watch that. And I want you to watch this one. So the dude in the red hoodie is Claire, and the dude on the left is Cancer. So it's gonna be is it gonna be Bison Mirror? That's
I don't remember.
Claire is Bison.
Anyone else.
Oh my god, that's terrible. Bison Mirror is.
Well, it might be a really intense match as well.
Let's see.
One of them gets in, fights an opening.
The other is really screwed. So let's see what's gonna happen. Let's see. The green bison, oh my god.
L bison.
Okay. So Kanso starts with a jump in, yeah. Well, welcome online
warriors. It's like warriors. They really like the jump.
Well, why not? Bison cannot walk, what else can he do? Nice scissors, counter poke with scissors, that's...
Well, Bison is not in center. He's one of the characters that have a good Russian fierce center.
Well, yeah, he does. It's kind of... It's not really that fast though, but... Fast enough. It's pretty solid actually.
And it also has a huge hitbox.
Yeah, it does. Yo, that was a big reversal out of
nowhere. Now it's back and forth.
So a head stomp for the win. Air to air head stomp. Well, you actually can play air to air with Bison when he head stomps, but you gotta like position yourself a little further. And it's really hard for Bison to position himself.
And Claire is stunned.
Yeah.
And Kansa has a full meter all on
top. That's a punish on the drop combo and wake up super. What the hell? Like yes. What's going on, guys? Come on.
No, but it's really hard to punish, so I guess I'll let it slide.
So Claire stuns it back and takes the round. That's crazy. Like they're just swinging back and forth. Like no shame. The jab and anti-air. Like jab is really consistent for most of their cast.
But
like you don't really get much off of it, but it's consistent.
But some of characters have really good jabs while others are like carrying.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Their jabs aren't that great.
So Cancer is getting stomped in the corner and now he's losing the round off of a super strong round from Claire. But at the same time, like you can't even tell what happened, like why Claire was able to beat Cancel. Yes, can you? It's kind of a scramble. Like they both jumped back and forth, and first round Cancel got his jump ins, and the next two rounds it's like Claire got his.
Yes, and if you notice, Cancel died with a full super and full V trigger, so he couldn't just answer back. It was really fast.
Oh, so we're being told that the names are backwards. So, Cancer won this match. Well, that really doesn't change much.
Yep.
So Cancer is the red bison, right? Yo, Cancer Kraken. So Cancer is the red bison. And he won the first game.
And it's just like that. Blair gets a huge combo, Cancer gets a huge combo.
Yo, the names are still backwards, right? That's Cancer, right? But that's Cancer.
Yes. Cancer is winning. Thank you.
And Cancer leads 1-0. Cancer leads 1-0. Okay, now everything's correct. And it's again like the first match. Somehow Claire takes the first round and then somehow Cancer dominates the second. Or am I not seeing something?
It's about adaptations, what I'm talking about.
Yeah. That was a really good crouch medium kick. It was really bad for Claire to press buttons after a whip throw, but he did and got punished and got ranked. So match point, Cancer. Yeah, that's how you play air-to-air with Bison. You just jump back. And if he flies into you, you hit him.
Turtle? No.
A lot of stun, and now... Okay. Why did he jump in the corner? What?
I guess... it might be called an old Russian tradition. Did he jump into the corner?
Oh my god, that's... Okay, that looks like... it looks like really... an online match. No, anti-air. Again. And what? It's the second time we see that slide. Like, it's the second time today I've seen, like, Bison slide without even V-trigger, without ever... Just slide. If you want to do a low, why don't you do crouch medium kick?
Well,